it's his third position in government, no? So maraming nagko-question bakit nandiyan pa siya. But I think in this case, just if you talk about this case and what's happening in the brouhaha over Sanchez, palagay ko tama yung decision ni Presidente. Tama yung tanggalin na siya kasi unang-una sinabi niya hindi niya alam na may department order pala sila. So clearly he's not coordinating with his superiors at maraming nadismaya dun talaga sa Sanchez case.
How about the possibility of him being transferred again for a fourth time?
Sana wag naman. Wag na lang sana, di ba? Kasi, if he wanted to serve, he served already. And kung saan siya pumunta, medyo nagkagulo eh. Mm. So, mas maganda siguro wag na lang.
Of course, the other important question is what happens next? Because he was fired, right? But how about the liabilities?
For
any possible liabilities for the release?
Well, if there are any cases that should be filed, then I think the authority should look into that. No? Sa ngayon, wala pa naman ako nakikita. There's a bit of, unless they discover some sort of bribery, they can pick around. No? Kasi sabi nga ni President, he's hearing a lot of things na freedom is for sale. No?
Yeah.
So, if they find any witness who can testify that he accepted money for these things, then he can be prosecuted for bribery and things like that.
But so far, based on the hearings in the Senate, you've had two already. You have another one this afternoon.
That's right.
What loopholes do you see? Because perception or perspective is that there's really a problem with the interpretation of the law. And number two, that certain Bucor officials took advantage of that supposed gray area.
That's right. I think what the consensus among the senators is that there seems to be an awful lot of discretion on the part of the Bucor officials. Parang they're like God, you know. And apparently, hindi pala sa batas because there's a department order issued by former Justice Secretary Kagiwa, who's now a Supreme Court Justice, that if you are convicted of murder or of homicide or of a crime meriting the penalty of life imprisonment, you should have gotten the permission of the Department of Justice or the Secretary of Justice, which none of the Bucor officials did. So, in a way, you could argue that these 1,900 heinous crimes, who were convicted of heinous crimes, talagang may merit na they should not have been released. They were released without the permission, and that is an extra safeguard under the law, under the executive order or the department order.
But
that,
the